So very good afternoon to all the teachers, students and parents who have joined. We will be starting our session in just few minutes. We are just waiting other students to join in. Yeah, very good afternoon to all the students. We will be just starting in few minutes. We are just waiting other students to join. So I'm just pasting the link, the live link. Okay, so you can send it across your group so that you can ask your friends to join in. So you can just share this link with your friends and ask them to join in. Yeah, we will be just starting in few minutes, students. So as like you know, it is scheduled at 3. Yeah, sure. So today, don't worry, like we will be doing complete work. Okay, so the complete work will be like we will be making it in the laptop, desktop first thing. Then we will be like, I will be like showing you how you can make this and complete this activity in your Android phone. Okay, and also I will show you that how you can submit it using your using your laptop into the dashboard, and also how we will be submitting it into the dashboard using an Android phone. So I will try to like cover all these things in today's session, so that if after this session you find a doubt, it will be easier for you to just see this. Okay, and also we will be doing a short recap, okay, of the last session. So we'll just wait for a few more minutes. Okay. Yeah, so Sneha, if you are not able to see the dashboard, so see, you already know that we have a website, and I'll just share the screen. So what you can do, students, you can just chat with us from here. Okay, so you have to just share your problem in this website. Okay, this is like ai.bcmf.in, that is the Mission AI website, and just send us your chat here, what exactly the problem you are facing, and we will connect to you. Also, the most important part is there will be a major chance that the live connection would be not there, but we will be replying you it in your email. Okay, so if you are giving your emails, please check that emails regularly. Okay, so just give 2 to 4 minutes, we will be starting soon. So marks of the quiz, you can see it on the top. So today we will be doing each and everything, don't worry. No, in main result, there will be some amount of marks will be added. Okay, not exactly the complete. So there will be a small weightage of it. But the most important part is you complete all the assignments. Okay, nothing should be left. Like it when towards the end of the camp, it should be 100% completed. That's something more important. Okay, students who are not able to sign in, we'll just see the problem, okay, and we'll help you. So we'll just start in 3 more minutes, students, okay? And right now I will request the student not to like send the chat right now on the website, okay? So which is the last day to submit the answer for this is, students, you have to submit your assignments daily. But if you buy in case you are finding any trouble, so you have to submit it everything before 28. Okay, but don't don't pile up the things, don't put on lagging it. Okay, try to complete daily exercises. So please tell you, I will give you a little brief about yesterday's session, and also let me just stop the share, let me just stop the chat and let me paste the link for yesterday's session. So although like we are sharing you all things in your email ID, okay, you can also ask us the things in like chat, in the website chat. Okay, you can ask the things in this chat as well. I'll just delete this chat and I'll just repost. So this is the link for the yesterday's session, although we have like sent it to you on your emails. Okay, so now it's 3 p.m. and it's the correct time to start. So today we are going to start with a little recap, because I know some of the students found a little difficulty because I know the pace was little high. Okay, but not a problem. We'll give you a short recap. So we got a little feedback from the teachers and students. So today we will try to keep the pace of the session slow, so that from all the students joining from very early classes also will be able to understand each and everything. So can you please just respond me on the chat that is my voice audible to you all? So can you please just give me a yes on the chat that my voice is audible? Okay. Yeah, today I won't take you too fast. Okay, I'll take you very slowly so that each and every part is completed. Okay. And is my language is good, right? Like you are not finding any problem with the language. Language is good. Okay. Okay, wonderful. Okay, so let's start. I'll just stop this presentation. I'll just take you first to the give you a short recap what exactly we did in like 5 to 7 minutes. Okay, and explain you some of the concepts. So I'll just stop this presentation. Okay, great. Okay, so I'll just share my screen and take you back to the PictoBlox screen to explain you the things. Okay, so now you can see a screen of like software, although like see the concepts are very same, right? There is no difference in concepts. The only difference is the view. The view in the software is little bigger, and in the Androids it is smaller, but the concept of blocks and everything is going to be very same. So what I want you to hear to focus is like what are the things we have just saw yesterday. I'll just give you a little brief. So yesterday we made a story. Okay, so what was the story? So story was of two characters. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'll just go and bring the two characters directly. Okay, I'll just find one lion. So now I just selected a lion here. Also, I had one more character that was a fox. Okay, so I'll just bring a fox. So we discussed yesterday that like we have already discussed this in a detail, but I'll just explain you that the first criteria is to set up the initial positions. And also we also discussed that every character or every sprite in the PictoBlox have their own sprites, right? So what I can do is I can fix the position of lion here. Okay, I want my lion to be here and my fox to be somewhat here. Also, we will be requirement of putting a backdrop. So I can just go to backdrop option and let me bring some good backdrop from the backdrop option. So let's take this jungle today. Okay, so as I said, there are two sprites, lion and fox. So we have to work with them separately. So I'll just give you a brief, okay? I'll just give you a short brief. So now the concept first was we used when green flag is clicked so that like both of the sprites can work together. Okay, so because if I will be in fox, I will put a when green flag is clicked, and when I'm going to press the green flag, everything under the lion, everything under the fox will start working together. Okay, so I just came into the lion, so you can see lion is selected. So what I want to do is I will just use this and I'll initiate it like putting up this go to. Okay, this will fix the position. Okay, similarly I will also fix the position, but before fixing a position for the fox, you can see fox is somewhat seeing in other direction. So how did I manage to make it see lion? Okay, so see students, first thing is point direction. So right now the sprite is pointing on the 90 degrees, so you can see, I'll just to show you, so you can see arrow is in this side, the face is in this side. If I bring this arrow on just opposite, so what is going to happen, and I'll just click this, so now you can see the faces are on the same side, but although sprite just took a rotation of all around. Okay, so I can change the rotation. You already know there is a block set rotation left to right. So what it is going to do is it will change its rotation. Okay, so now these two blocks I am ready with. Also, I will just keep it behind. Okay, and I will fix its initial position. So this was the part. So this was the part where we fixed the initial position. And after that, we learned about a costume. So what are the costumes? I have already explained. So there was a question, students, in the quiz. So many students have done that. Like the question was, with how many costumes we can make an animation? So I think the options were 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, or yeah, 1, 3, 4, 5, something like this it was. So students, I wanted to tell you this, like with a single costume, you can't make an animation, right? Because if it is only one costume and it will move like it, so this is not an animation. Animation is something where it should move its leg and like we should be able to see some motion, right? So this is why the answer was all the 3 points on that question, except the option which was having a one, because with one costume, you can't make an animation. After that, students, we just learned the concept that we can change the costume using the switch costume methods. Okay. We also learned that we can switch the backdrop using the switch backdrop. And there was a very important concept where we learned about like sending a message internally. So that was broadcasting the message. Okay. So this was something which meant like I am sending a message internally to the other sprite. So like you, I'll just remove this, like all these. And if after this, I want like, let's bring some hello. Okay. And after hello, I'm just broadcasting a small message. So what am I doing is I'll just write the name hello. Okay. And now I'm sending this hello message internally to the fox. Okay. And other sprites also. So, but we are working with only 2 sprites. So now what you wanted to do is you have to hear that sound, right? And how you can hear that is, you will go to event and you will see when I receive hello. And what you want is when you see hello, you want fox to also reply with hello lion. Okay. So although like this is not a complete story because this is just a short recap of the concepts which we have learned yesterday. Okay. So this is like just making you understand the different concepts. Okay. So now if I'm going to press green flag, so now you can see it said hello and hello lion. So what happened is like it just went so fast that we were not able to see the changes. So what we can do here is we will just use the wait, right? So we have also discussed this. So some students in like some operating system, like in iPhone, somewhere finding some problem of using point and everything. So don't worry, you can put it, okay, not an issue. Instead of wait, if you want to say something, so you can also use looks, and here is like say hello for 2 seconds. Okay, so this will work in the same purpose. So now you can see after that it said hello lion. Okay, now again you can also see I have used hello lion here instead of it. I can just put it for 2 seconds. So this will, now I'll just press the green flag. So now it will say hello, and after that fox said hello lion. So I have not animated the things because I think that part is very, very clear to all of you. Like bringing and moving the steps with move 10 steps, right? And changing the costumes under the repeat we were doing to check. So we were, the blocks which we used yesterday was repeat. And we tested that for how much time the lion is coming to somewhere place here. And after that, we set up the final call for the repeat. So like if I take 5 and I will ask it to move 10 steps. And also I wanted to see the change in the costume. So what I'm going to do is I'll just bring the change in costume from B to C. So I have a B and I have kept it C. Also, you know that whenever we are switching a costume, we need a wait. And why do we need a wait? So that we can see it properly. We also use move 10 or move 5, anything you want in between, so that everything looks synchronized. I should say synchronized. I mean, it should look in a good view. So if I'll now press it, you will be able to see. Right, you. So it just said hello because I just kept it hello on the top. Okay, so if in case you want it, so you can remove this hello and put it somewhere here. Okay, so this will give you the exact something which we made yesterday. So now you can see the lion is walking towards the fox. Okay, and after reaching a certain point, it is going to say hello. So I have not given any instructions to fox here of movement, right? So I have just made it initial steps, and just an arm hearing in, I should say, the previous message which has been sent from lion. So this was something which we worked yesterday. So I'll not take more time on it. I think we should move to the today's session as well. So I'll just open up a new file. Okay, I'll just stop a share. So now I think everyone will be very clear on it. So there is no WhatsApp group linked here. Okay, and if you want to know about anything, you can send me a chat on the website, right? And I will be answering to you as soon as possible. So I'll help you with submission and everything. You don't have to worry. Okay, so I'll just ask a question now. That is this part very clear to everyone? So let me just ask it from all of you. So please give your polls, students. I think maximum of you might be now very easy with it, right? Because we have discussed it 2 times. You also have a recording. So you can also look around in the recording, not an issue. Great. I can see a very good number, around 90. Okay, still if even one student is not able to understand, please look into the video. Okay, and if in case you are finding a trouble, please reach out to us using a chat option on website. We'll try to give you more clarity on it. There is no problem, because we want each and every student in this camp should be able to learn and understand each and every part which has been taught in all sessions. Okay, I'm facing some problem open after the registering on the phone. So not a problem, Trisha, I'll help you with that. Okay, so I'll take care of those things, don't worry, student. Let's first I didn't get the replay video. So replay video is first I'll just show you where exactly you can see it in the dashboard. You also get it on the email, so you don't have to worry. So now let's cover today's part. Okay, I'll just start with today's session, that is Beetle in the Maze. Okay, so students, basically we are going to make a game. Okay, so although this game might look very easy to you on the first go, but this game is going to clear so many concepts that you will be able to make your own wonderful games, and you will be able to understand what are the things in the game which is required to be understood previously making and starting a game building. Okay, so again, there are 3 things. Okay, we always work on that basis, that is planning, writing and testing. Right, so we will do that in a similar fashion, so that no one finds a problem and everything is very clear to us. Okay, so also I'm trying to keep my pace slow for the session. If in case you want me to get little more slow, do let me know in the chat. Okay, I'll try to keep it more slow. Okay, I'll tell you, students, don't worry about uploading and everything. We are going to take care of this each and every step today. Okay, so now let's understand. So I want now no more questions about anything. Okay, first watch the complete session what we are taking, and trust me, by today's session your each and every doubt which you are sending in on the chat will be cleared. Okay, trust me. So I'm going to take care of each and every part. Okay, so let's go and understand how we can make the games. That one of the game is Beetle in the Maze. So we are going to first understand that how we can control the character in the game, what is game development, how we can do a scoring in the game. Okay, now the game, what we are going to make today is Beetle in the Maze. So you can see a small beetle. Okay, so I would request students, all students, not to like chat in between. Okay, great, great. Okay, so now focus. I want everyone's focus on the session. Okay, and I don't want to see any chat till I'm asking you to put anything there. Okay, so hope you will like follow my steps. I want no one to send any chat till I'm not asking any question. Okay, I don't want to like disable the chat, but I want this from your side that you should not send any chat. Okay, so let's start and understand it very, very easily. So you can see the name of the game is Beetle in the Maze. Okay, so what exactly the Beetle in the Maze is? So in the like childhood, you are already in the childhood, but you might have played this type of game in comics using pencil and pen. Okay. So there was a maze, a small maze generally, and we take the pen and try to come out of the maze, right? But now we are going to make this game into the PictoBlocks. Okay, and how we can do that is, it is going to be very, very easy. The most important thing is you have to concentrate. So now students, you can see a beetle, you can see a maze also. So maze, what exactly maze is? So maze, it means like in Hindi, I should say a bhool bhulaiya, I think we call it bhool bhulaiya. So basically it's a like a pathfinder game. Okay, you can think of pathfinder. So basically you have to find a path to get to this apple. Okay, so now students, just think that how we can make it. Okay, so why I'm giving you time is because I want you to plan this. Okay, I can totally plan, there is no problem. Okay, but I want you to plan this. Okay, so just think that I want a game here where I want my beetle to go to the apple. So just give a 1 minute of thinking inside you. Okay, that, and the first part we are doing is planning, right? So what should be things we should take care while making this game? Okay, so now the things is, what are the things we have to take care? So I'll just take you. So, okay, the first step, do you all agree with this? We will be in need of bringing the beetle in the game. Okay, of course, Tanvi has written maze, of course. We will be bringing the maze. So all, do you agree with this? That we will be in need of bringing the beetle in the game. Okay, I can see, yes, agree. Okay, wonderful. Can I see more responses? Yes, wonderful. So because see student, it's not like just coding it. We want you to think about it, okay? So that you will be able to make more games. It's not only just exactly I can see some of the answers, backdrop means. So now we will be seeing that how we are going to do it in laptop and like in the everything. And I'll just stop this presentation. Although you can refer to this presentation in your dashboard, I will show you. So yeah, so we all agree here that we will be in requirement of some of the sprites, okay, and we will be also in requirement of some of the backdrops. So let me just share my screen back. Okay, so don't worry, I'm starting with mobile. Or what we can do today is I will take you to the mobile version first. Okay, so just give me a moment. Okay, so we will start with mobile version. So this will give us more clarity, because yesterday we took the laptop first. So let's take today the Android first. Okay, so now students, what we are going to do here is, you can see on my Android screen, I hope everyone is able to see my Android screen. Can you please respond me on the chat? Are you all able to see? Okay, I can see, yes. So I'll just give a full screen here. Okay, and I'll also remove this so that like, which is much more clear. So the first step, I'll go to MySpace. Okay, after going to MySpace, you can see two options. Okay, so after reaching MySpace, there is a plus play button as well as there is a plus button. So what are these two buttons? I have already explained you that play button will take you to the scripting area where you program in the previous program, like whatever you were programming. Okay, but plus will start a new program. So today we want to work with a new program. So definitely we should choose the new program button, that is plus. So now it will be start coming and it will take just a few seconds. Okay. So now I think everything is very visible to all of you. So now student, you can see the Toby here, although we will not be in requirement for Toby. Okay, so let's start like making it and planning it. So as I said, the first thing we what in the planning we know is we will need a beetle. The second is we will need a maze. Okay, the third thing in the planning is we want our beetle to move into the maze. Okay, that my beetle should move right, my beetle should move left, my beetle should move up and down, right? So this is coming all under the planning. Okay, we are planning this. What exactly we need to make the game. Also, you have to think, right, that there should be a point system. Okay, because if we are playing a game, there should be a point system. And every time beetle is touching the walls of the maze, the beetle should come back to its main place. Okay, so I'll just explain you this part also. So let's start like first deleting the Toby. So how we can delete the Toby is we have to just click on the Toby and it will come up with the three options and you have to choose the third option which will help you to delete the sprite. Okay, so now you have to click on the center, that is the adding any sprite option, which is a teddy bear with a small plus, and let's select a beetle. So I'll directly because I know you guys are now well versed that how you can like find the sprites. Okay, just give me a moment. So I'll directly find it because actually it becomes little difficult for me for typing into the like this phone. So I'll try to find beetle directly by scrolling it. So now I can see the beetle. Okay, on my screen you can see the beetle has came just behind the So I'll just select a beetle here. This will bring up a beetle. Okay, so I hope this was the first planning we did. Now let's bring up a backdrop, that is a maze. Okay, so I'll go to the backdrop option, that is the first option, and I will again click it and go into the backdrop settings. Okay, so now in this I will get an option, the first option, that add a backdrop, and we already have a direct maze backdrop, so you can directly select that. Right, so now students, you can see that my beetle is ready, the backdrop is ready. I'll just go back to the scripting area. Okay, so now students, what you have to see is that you can just drag the beetle here and there, right? But we want it to be moved with the arrow keys. So how the arrow keys are going to come? Let me just try to show you. Actually something has just appeared on my screen. Okay, so let me just show you. Just beside a green flag, there is an option of full screen. So you have to click that option, okay? So when you are going to click on that option, you will be able to see the gamepad. So this is we are trying to do in the like Android phones and like the smartphones. Okay. So basically we will be using these arrow keys, that is up, down, right, left, to make the movement of beetle. Okay, so I'll just go back to the scripting area. So for that, again, I have to press that button. Actually, that has been little hide. Okay. Let me just give me a moment. I'll just try to open it again. Okay, so I'll just bring the things again back. Okay, so now also you know, students, that you have to keep saving it. So please click on save, okay? And just you can please write the name as per the lecture, okay? Or I should say as per the lesson, because this will help you to submit and find the correct file. So like, let me write game and maze game, okay? A game maze I have written. Now I'll just, okay. By mistake, I just removed it. I'll again write that name, maze game, and keep saving it, because otherwise you might lose the data. Okay, so now this was the part, okay, which was very important, okay, and you have to like work out with the beetle and the maze, and now we will be seeing those part. Okay, so this was the first part of planning. And as I said you, that you will be working with these arrow keys. You can see when you are going to on the full screen mode. And I'll just bring that back again. Okay, so now I will explain the codes into the laptop, how we are going to do it. Because like making the script here, it becomes little bit difficult. Because sometimes what happens, this screen might be not so big for you, okay? And I won't be able to like make it much more zoom, okay? So for the viewing purpose, it's better. I'll explain you the script part in the laptop. So this was the initial stage, which like, this is only the difference in the, I should say, the laptop and the Android. Otherwise, you have to use these only blocks, right? These are very same in the phone, as well as this is very same into the laptop. So I'll just stop my share here. And I will move. So I'll now share my screen. Now I'll explain you in laptop each and everything. And also I will explain you the submission process through the phone also. So you don't have to worry. Okay, just stay with me, stay calm and understand each and everything what I'm trying to tell you. Okay, so right now it won't move, dear, because we haven't written any script. So now I'm going to explain you what we have to do for the coding. Okay, so I think my screen would be visible. So let me, like, you can choose a sprite beetle here. Okay, and I'll just remove this and I'll choose a backdrop from a backdrop option, that is maze. Okay, so this part was only the different in laptop and in Android. Rest whatever I'm going to do is very same. So students who are going to do it on the phone also, they are going to make it similarly how exactly I'm going to do it. So now, student, the first thing comes up here is, if I just put a beetle somewhere in middle, so don't you think this beetle size is very big? Okay, so every time it won't be able to go from here to there, right? Because this is very big. So how we can manage the size of the beetle? Okay, so what I'm going to do is, there is an option to set the size. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, so let me just, I think it's in blocks. So I will set its size, instead of 100, I'll just take 60. Okay, and I just click it here. So now you can see it is somewhat looking good. Okay, so I have bring it on the 60. So now there is a question. Okay, so because we have discussed this already, so I want you all to answer this. If I want my beetle should face in this direction, in the front direction. Okay, so right now you can see it's facing on right direction. But if in case I want my beetle to face on the front direction, what should I use? Which block I should use? I repeat the question. If now you can see my beetle is looking on the left hand, right hand side. If I want my beetle to look onto the straight, what should I do? So I'll just stop my share and I want your answers on the screen. Okay, point in direction. Okay, right, sir, turn 90 degree. Wonderful. Point in direction. Point in direction. Wonderful. Zero. Okay, okay. So direction. Yeah, good, good. Yeah, wonderful. So see, whether you are putting correct degree, that doesn't matter, because that is something you will be doing when you will doing it practically. Okay, so I hope my screen is visible to all of you. Is my screen visible again back to all of you? Can you please respond me on chat? Can you please respond me on chat? Is my screen visible? Oh, students, I got, okay, yes, I can see. Okay, I'll just, what I'll do is I'll just share it back. Okay, yes, the yes was the call. So I don't know, like, why is it little working weird? Just give me a moment, huh? Okay, so I'm back here. Am I all already? Yeah. So no, actually, sometimes in the live sessions, you know, like due to some connections and some technical glitch, it happens. So now am I audible to all of you? Can you see me now? Yes. Okay. Okay. Now I'm visible. Wonderful. Yeah. So now I'm going to just share my screen back. Okay. And we'll directly go to the picto blocks here. So student, just give me a 2 minute. I think there is some technical problem. I'll just take 2 minutes. So now I think I will be I'm visible, right? Am I audible to all of you? So I'll tell you how you are going to change the size of the beetle. Okay, wonderful. Yes, yes, okay. So I'll just directly share my screen and take you to the So can you please respond me on the chat? That is my this screen is visible to all of you. My PictoBlocks screen is visible to all of you. Can you please respond me on the chat? No, okay, no. Let me just stop the share. Okay, so okay, students, I'm sorry for like, I think there's some problem. So just give me 2 more minutes. I'll just rectify it. Okay. So I think now I'll be visible to you all, right? And I'll try to like share my screen. Okay, so now everything looks good. So you will be able to see my screen in a few moments. Okay, wonderful. So now I think you are well, you can see my screen, right? So as we were discussing, okay, that the first thing what we require is to set the size of the beetle. Okay, so I want everyone to focus here. Okay, so now please just see that first thing what we want to do is we have to set the size. So my question was, what do we want to do to make this beetle look in front direction? So can you please put the answers again?
First thing what we want to do is
okay, can you please put the answers back again here? Okay, point direction, wonderful. So this is what I was expecting from you all. So let me bring this point direction here, okay, and let me just put it somewhat like this. Okay, if I'm going to click it here, so this is what we wanted, right? That my beetle should be pointing on this direction. So first thing what we are doing is we are setting up the first thing. So we have pointed it to the zero. Now every time my game start, what I want is, instead of somewhere here or somewhere here, I want my beetle should be always at the first position, initial position, this. Okay, and I'll just also reduce the size here for a little bit. Okay, so now you can see to always start with this position, what do we need? So you know we have an option go to. So what we are going to do is every time it start, it should be at this place only. So let me take somewhere this here so it would look good. Okay, so every time it start, I want these three things to happen, that my beetle side should go somewhere around this, my beetle should be looking forward, and also as I said, my beetle should always come to this side. Now the students, the parts come of movement, so how we can handle it? So just see this, and I want everyone to keep their focus here, and this is very, very important, and it's going to be very interesting. So I have brought one block, that is when green flag is clicked. Okay, so now students, what we are going to do? So there is a block which says forever. What is the use of this block? So this block helps you to check the things again and again, again and again. Okay, make the blocks work again and again. So like we have already discussed, if in case I will put move 10 steps here and click the forever, so now you can see my beetle is moving in the front direction, but we are not going to do this way. Okay, so what now I can do? So now you can see here, like my beetle reached somewhat place here, right? But when I'm going to press green flag, every time it is going to come this year. So like if in case my beetle is somewhere here, and if I'm going to press green flag, so this will come directly to the initial position due to these three blocks. So now I'll put a forever, and we are going to have this block. So what exactly is this? If, and in center you can see an hollow space, and that is then. So what do we do in this hollow space? So in this hollow space, students, we are going to write a condition. Now the question comes, what exactly is the condition? So students, any question which is giving you a answer in true or false, we can call it as a condition. So in operators, you can see there are some operators which you daily use in your math classes, mathematics classes. So now what you can do here is, like this is type of a condition. Okay, so just tell me what should be the answer to this green block. 1 > 50, is it true or is it false? Can you please put your answers on the chat? So is this green, like 1 > 50, is it true or it's false? Yeah, of course, Ishant, very perfectly written. Sir, Boolean. Okay, false, false. Okay, wonderful, false. Okay, so students, you don't have to be confused with this, right? One is greater than 50 is going to give you false. So anything which is going to give you true or false, like if I add two zeros here, so now it should give us true, right? It is going to give us true. So this is something we call as a condition. So now if I'm just keeping this back, but if in case I want to check the sensing, so what sensing is? So here, students, you can check whether any key is pressed, whether any color is touched. Okay, so let's see this in depth. So now again, you can see this is something in hexagonal block, and this is going to also give me true or false. So it is written that is space key pressed. So I'll just change space to up arrow. Okay, so now it will say false because right now I'm not putting up false, I'm not like pressing it. But now if I'll just press up arrow, so right now I'm pressing up arrow in my keyboard and I'm going to click it, so it is going to give me true. So now students, you have to see that I'm going to put it here. Okay, so now if this condition is true, it is the blocks which will be inside this part, okay, which white part are going to be worked on. If in case it is false, it is not going to work on. So like if in case I have used move 10 step, I'm just keeping for an idea. So if I'm going to give move 10 step, so if this condition is true, then only move 10 step will work. Otherwise, if this condition is false, the block inside it is not going to work. Okay. So now what I'll do is instead of move 10 steps, I'll just put this inside a forever and let me show you how exactly it works. So again, what do we want here? So we want move 10 steps, of course, but along with that, I will be also in use requiring a point direction. I'll show you why. So why do we need it? Okay, I'll show you this part. So now if in case I'll just remove this and I press this forever. Okay, now every time I'm going to press this, you can see my beetle is moving up, right? In the similar fashion, students, we have to make four blocks. Okay, so what will be those four blocks? So I'll just put it here. Okay, so now it was up. So I'll let me just put up there itself. Okay. Give me a little burst here. Okay, yeah. So now if in case I have checked up arrow, similarly I'm going to check down arrow. But in down arrow, what I want is I want it to see at the back side, right? That's why I'm putting it 180. And now if I'm going to put it and if I'm going to press it, okay, so how we can check it is like I'll just put this to both of them in the forever and now I'll just press it here. So now you can see it is going to the front, and if I'm pressing it back button, it is taking a back. So you can see it is also turning. So this turning is happening due to this point in direction. Okay, you want me to go slow. Okay, not a problem. I'll just go slow. So let me just repeat this part. Okay, not an issue. Okay, so see, so let me just first clear this doubt of point direction. So I think this might be giving you an like little confusion. So see, if I want my beetle to go in forward direction, so what I want is it should see the front, right? But if I want my beetle to come back, so what I want is I want my beetle to see in the back, right? So I want my beetle to see in the back. So this is why what we are doing is we are using this point direction. So like every time I'm going to press up arrow key, it will see in the first, in the front side, right? Now let me put it inside here. And now you can see what am I doing is I'm trying to check whether I'm pressing up arrow, whether I'm pressing down arrow. Similarly, I'll duplicate this. I'm going to check right and left. So I'll click here, right arrow, and just tell me. So till here, can you please tell me that if in case I want my beetle to move in right direction, what should I put in this point direction? So this is your question. Please answer me this question. So if in case I want my beetle should move into the right direction, right when the right arrow is pressed. Okay, I can see somewhere, okay, 90, wonderful, right arrow, perfect, 90. Okay, perfect. So it's perfect. So yeah, of course you have to put it at 90 because if I'm going, want it to go to the right direction. Now I want, so this will be your homework actually. I don't want to reveal it. So right now, let me just directly put a left arrow and I will choose it here, -90. Okay. So now I'll just add all these students. Okay, so I'm going to add this to not just below each other. Okay, I'm sorry. So I'll just add one each other. I'll just stack this all one at the each other. Okay, after stacking them, I'll just put it inside the forever. So let me just shorten this so that it will be like visible to you all much more clearly. So I think this is visible. So this is something what we are doing here is I am first checking whether up arrow key is pressed or the down arrow key is pressed or the right arrow key is pressed or the left arrow key is pressed. So let me just start it. So if I can roam here and there now. Now I can use all the arrow keys and I can roam here and there wherever I want. So I think this part is very clear to all of you, right? Okay, so now you can see I was moving very easily. Now student, the second part is, okay, so this was the first part. Now also I want to check, right? Because I'm making a game, so I should be able to like check the things. So what are the things what I want to check is first that hope my beetle is not touching the black line. So how can I do that? So I'll go in control. Again, I'm going to bring if, but before it, I will take a forever because I want to check it again and again. Okay, so if, so yeah, here you can see students, it is saying touching color. Okay, it is in respect to the beetle. So it is saying beetle is touching this color. So I will just click on color. Okay, I'll just click on fill button and I'll just take this color directly. Okay, and after selecting this color, I'll put it here. So this is somewhat is I am checking whether my beetle is touching a black color or not. If it is touching, so what do I want? I want it to come back to the initial position, right? So I have kept these three blocks, right, for initial position. So I'll just duplicate this and put it inside. So now you will be able to see this part is if my beetle is going to touch any of the black lines, it will come to its initial position. Okay. So let's keep it in forever and press a green flag and let's try to do it. So now you can see I'm just moving. So you just saw I touched the black line. Again, I touched the black line. So wherever I'm going to touch a black line, it will send me to the initial position. Okay. So I think this might be very easy. So students, I would request not to paste your links and everything here. I will be, if red color is touched, then of course, very perfectly written by Berlin Core. So now what we are going to do is we are going to test the same thing with a red color. That if the red color is pressed, basic motive is I want my to beetle to go till here, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to test it with the red color. So again, I will just put it, take this and come here with the red color. And after what do I want here? I want here is it should get stopped. So in control, you are going to see there is a block which says stop all. So this is going to stop everything. Okay. So this is going to stop everything. That's why I'm putting it here. Now also along with this, you can also work with the move. Okay, so what are the moves? So what you can do here is, now my game is auto ready. Okay, it's already ready and I can play it, there is no problem, but there is no point system. So, but how I can bring a point system? Okay, how I can bring a point system? So just I'll take 2 to 3 minutes, okay? So to explain you this, so now you can see I just reached and everything is stopped. Once I touch this red color, I have to press the green flag again. So now if I want to work with the points, so I'll go to variable. What is variable? So variable is a set, like you can understand it, a box. Okay, and where exactly you are going to store some number or some alphabet or some word. So I'll just click on make variable. I'll just put it move. You can put it anything you want. Let's keep it a number and okay. And what I want here is set move to zero. What this block is going to do is every time my game is starting, okay, it will keep it to zero. Okay, every time it is starting, it will start with zero. And every time this is a block which says change move by one. So this is going to increase the move by one. Okay, like it is one, so it will become two. If it is two, so it will become three. If it is three, so it will become four. So now what you have to do is you will just put it somewhere here in this part where it is touching the black line. Okay, because every time it will touch a black line, we should call it as a move. So what I can do is now I'll just click on the red, and now you can see, can you please answer me what is the move right now? Can you please tell me the value of move right now? So this will be same into the mobile, students. It will be very same into the mobile. So can you please tell me what is the value of the zero? What is the value of the move? Okay, zero. I'm sorry. I just by mistakenly just told you the answer. So now if I'm going to touch a black line, so now you can see it became one, right? I want all of your focus here. So now it become two. So the objective of this game is now that I have to complete this game in the least moves. Okay, so least amount of move I have to take. I just got failed again. Okay, it's a little good game. You will be loving it while playing. So you can take out a little bit of time playing it. Okay, and also practicing it. Now the things come up regarding how we are going to submit this. Okay, so first thing is you have to save this. So how you can save it is I'll just put this maze game. And I just wrote a wrong spelling. I'll just put a maze game, and also I will put mission AI 2. Okay, so I'll save it with me because I need to share. So after this, I'm going to tell you that how we are going to do it with the mobile, like how you can submit it with mobile. So I'll just save it. Okay, so now the project is saved, and I'll stop my share for a moment. And let me just come back to your screen. Okay, so I'll just give me a moment. Huh? So I'll just open that project. That was somewhere in PictoBlocks. So I'll just go to PictoBlocks once. Just give me 2 minutes. I'm just searching that project. Okay, so now I've just opened it. So I wanted you to show you from very beginning. So I'm just sharing it again. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. So now this was the game, okay? So here, what you have to do here is, student, you have to click on files. Okay. So the first option in your computer will be file. And here you have to click on generate a file sharing link. So I'll just click it here. So it will take a little bit of time. Okay. And you can now copy this link. Yeah, I'll just take 2 to 3 minutes more, students. Okay. So you have to copy this link, okay? Once it is set copied, so now you have to go to your dashboard, okay? So just see this very, very carefully. Okay, I will be showing, I will try to show you all this with mobile also. So we will go to the login page. There I'll give my password and ID, like I will give my ID and password. Okay, and I'll just log in here. Okay, now I'll go to my bootcamp. So here there was a problem for some students that they are not able to see anything under this bootcamp. So students, you have to go to here, okay, explore more. Okay, so just click on this explore more. Once you'll be clicking here on explore more, you will be coming to this page that is AI Bootcamp Batch 2. Okay, you have to put this somewhere into the basics of make a game. So you will start click it here. And here you are where you are able to see this slide. Just above it, you will be able to see the, you just above this, you will be able to see this, I should say the video. Okay, so like just in make a story, let me just show you. So in the make a story, because the replay video for this will be uploaded after this, right? So let me just show you of make a story. I've clicked on make a story. So see student, here you can see the session video. Okay, then you can see the session lecture. Okay, you can see the session lecture. Okay, and just below it, you have to make a like make a story quiz. Okay, so you can put it somewhere here. Okay, so once you will be selecting it, so today's project has to be submitted into make a game. So I'll go back to make a game. So this was just for showing you. Okay, and I'll just go to make a game quiz, and here you have to basically start the quiz. So this quiz will be starting up somewhere here. Okay, and you will be working with this, and you have to paste that link from there to here. Complete this quiz, and then you have to click on finish quiz. Okay, so this was the part I wanted to cover with the laptop. Let me directly take you to the phone and show you how you can do this. So it will take hardly 2 more minutes, students. So now, because I want everyone should be able to do this, there should be no problem. Okay, so I will directly show you how we are going to do it here. Okay, so the PictoBlax has opened in my screen. So I won't take time to like making the script and everything. I'll just, I already have that maze game with me. So what I'm going to do is, I am going to show you how you can make the link out of it. So I have to press this game a little deep, and you will be able to see a small tick over here. Once you will be able to see a tick, you can see on the top, the first option is for the link. You have to click that, it will create a global link. Okay, you have to copy this to the clipboard. Now it has been copied. Now what you have to do is, students, you have to go to the website. So I'll just try to go to the website. So I'll just log into the page and show you. Okay, so now you can see this is a login page. Okay, and now you have to click, and I'll just choose this. I use demo, and I'll just log in here. After logging in here, you will be able to like get to see this. Okay, so now what you have to do again is, you have to just scroll down, okay, and your upcoming boot camps, you will be able to see this explore more. Click on this explore more. Okay, when you are going to click on this explore more, this will again open something like which we have just seen, and you have to put this. Okay, so now the students were saying where exactly is the video in it. So you can see, if I'll just show you by going into a make a story. So I'll go to make a story, and here you can see the video is here. Okay, the session slide is here, and just below it is a quiz. Okay, so you have to just do every day same procedure. You have to copy that link, come to this like a make it. So today we'll make a game. So you have to come to make a game, and you have to like after you will start a quiz, and you have to paste the link into the description in the fourth. So it will be depending upon your front, like it can be coming on first, second, third. So after pasting this and solving all this questions, you have to click on finish quiz. Once it's done, your part is completed. Okay, so I'll just stop my share here. Okay, so I hope there were so many things to cover, so it took a little bit of long. Okay, but I think now the things are very clear. So today's assignment is to make the game and submit the project. Okay, although like if you will find any trouble, please feel free to contact us on the chat. Okay, you already know. So I hope everything is clear till now. We are just going to conclude the session. Just give me, I'd like to ask some questions. So is everything clear to you guys? Like now how to submit and each and everything. I hope everything is clear because we have done it in very, very detail. Okay, still if you are not clear with this, don't worry, you will be receiving the link in your emails. Okay, and you will be able to do that. Okay, wonderful. Okay, so this was all for today's session. Thank you all for joining it. Hope you have enjoyed it. Hope I have like made you understand each and every concept, and day by day we are going to work much more better. Even I will try my much best so that I can make you understand each and everything. So thank you all for joining. Okay, and please feel free to contact us using the website chat option, and hope you are enjoying this. Thank you back again. We'll meet you tomorrow.